The BL2 Laboratory, which is short for the Brain and Language Laboratory, is a very exciting initiative at Gallaudet University. I'm thrilled to be part of this wonderful moment in Gallaudet's history. The laboratory will allow Gallaudet to establish its own neuroimaging center. This is very unusual for any university in the United States. Most universities have neuroimaging centers, but they're part of medical complexes, they're part of hospitals, and a scientific researcher must share the time on the scanner with all the doctors who need to use the scanner for medical reasons. Here, Gallaudet has its own research-dedicated neuroimaging laboratory. Decades we have studied how knowledge comes into the human brain through sound, how concepts are formed through sound, how information is exchanged through sound. VL2 is adding new revolutionary information to the scientific and public world. VL2 is studying how knowledge enters through the eyes, how visual percepts enter through the eyes and get translated into knowledge. We use the existence of sign language and deaf people and deaf culture as an exciting window into this information to widen the perspective of how human beings form knowledge, and through this new lens to show stunning advantages that visual processing can afford to all visual learners and to all people. It's almost as if only one modality received the lion's share of the attention, and now finally this very important modality, namely vision, it's getting its fair share and showing how processing in that modality affords a young child, a person, surprising attentional, cognitive, and linguistic advantages that we never knew were possible before. We have found that with precision, the identical brain tissue that we thought was special to processing sound also processes human sign languages, and that the course of acquisition in sign language is identical to the acquisition of speech. And this teaches us that the human brain is not exclusively searching for sound. Instead, it's searching for the patterns that are pressed into the hands or onto the tongue. The brain doesn't care what you give it. It will press out its search for patterns and its production of patterns on the hands or the tongue, and will do so equally.
FNIRS uses light to measure where neural activities happen in the brain. Because it only uses light, we're able to take a look at young infant brains.
Revolutionizing the idea of early intervention, here we can see the development of very specific brain tissue that's important for language, and we can see when something goes wrong. We can see it before the child even begins to produce language. Now, most diagnostic tests for language problems with a young child occur when the child is age 3 or age 5. We can detect children who are at risk for language problems well before they even are those ages, well before they're age 3 or 5, even as early as a few months old. And the benefit of that is we can design highly targeted therapies that really address remediation of the specific language aspects that they will need support with. The future is going to bring many research projects and many attempts to translate the research into meaningful application to education and educational policy. at the specific scientific level. My work has led me into brain tissue that we used to think was dedicated to sound, we now know is dedicated to temporal patterning that's true of all world languages, sign language and spoken languages. Not only do we now know that sign languages are real languages because of the linguistic commonality that all languages share, not only do we know that sign languages are a real language because of the cultural commonality that all languages share, but we now know that sign languages are real languages because they are biologically equivalent. The human brain does not discriminate between the hands and the tongue. People discriminate, but not our biological human brain.